Hi Philothea. Every meditation is a thought, but every thought is not a meditation. In this first episode on meditations, let us look into what is meditation.
Welcome.
In meditation, our spirit is like a sacred bee. It goes here and there on the flowers of divine mysteries to draw from them the honey of divine love. A meditation is simply a mystical rumination. A devout human spirit in meditation is similar to the bee, which in springtime flies here and there over flowers, with a purpose to gather honey. When it finds honey, it sucks it and loads itself with it. Then it carries it to the hive to skillfully work on it. In the same way, devout human spirit goes from mystery to mystery, not at random but with determination and of set purpose, to find motives of love or some heavenly emotions. Once the human soul has found them, it draws them to itself, relishes them and loads itself with them. It brings those motives and emotions and located them in its heart, separate what it sees suitable for its progress, makes decisions appropriate to the time and temptation. The desire of obtaining divine love makes us meditate. The love that is obtained causes us to contemplate. Meditation is the mother of love, contemplation is her daughter. The meditations on the last four things or the great truths of death, judgment, and hell, and God's love will be useful to you, provided that you always end with an act of confidence in God. To eat is to meditate. Meditating, we chew the spiritual food, turning the side and the between the teeth of our reflection to grind, crush and digest, which is done with some difficulty. To drink is to contemplate, it is done without difficulty and resistance, with delight and ease. So we are out of ourselves to be fully in God. When you meditate on God, your whole being will be filled with Him and you will learn His attitudes and model your actions on His. Every soul or devout human spirit must be enlightened and instructed in Him, by Him and for Him. As a child learns to speak by constantly listening to its mother, so we remaining close to the Savior in meditation and observing His words, His actions and His loving desires, His works and His actions, shall learn with the help of His grace to will to speak and act like Him. In the next episode, we will see how one should prepare for a good and fruitful meditation. Thank you.
Live Jesus.